Good morning, everyone. Now, today we are going to revise the topic pattern. Now, few questions are written on the board. Just let us recapitulate the pattern, and this topic is also very important, and it will increase as much as you will practice at home. It will increase the timing level, and you can solve very easily. You can follow the pattern and you can understand very easily, because if this type of questions need practice, so as much as you will practice, it will be easier for you to solve it. So let us go for the first question. See, it is written here 98, then 87, then 76. From the given numbers we can follow that, see here 98, then alternate 87. The first number is 8, so here it is written 8. Then 7, again next number is 76. So just the last number is becoming the first number of the next number. So here 76, so it will be obviously 6, 5, then 5, 4, 4, 3, 3, 2. Now, see, again I am repeating, you can understand. See here the number is 9, 8. So here it is ending with 8, and the next number is starting with 8. Again it is ending with 7, the next number is starting with 7. Here it is ending with 6, so here it will start with 6, and again 6, 5, so it is ending with 5, so it is starting with 5, 5, 4, and just the previous number. So 4 will start with the next number, 4, 3, then 3, 2. Did you understand? Now let us go to the next question. See, 100, 110, 120. From the given number, we can understand that it is skipping in tens. It is jumping in tens. So we have to count and we have to find out. So here it is 100, then 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110. That means it is jumping in tens. So 100 and then 110. So again 110, it is becoming 120. Now next we will do 120. Then jumping in 10, it will become 130. So after jumping in 10s, again it will become 140. So when we are counting, we will get the numbers. And you know the table of 10. So skipping in 10s means jumping in 10s. We will count in 10. So 140. Then again skipping in 10, it will become 150. Then it will become 160. So we are skipping in 10. So next. Next is A1. Then B2. C3. That means alphabets plus the numbers. So first is alphabet and the next one is number. So here it is A, then C, B, then C, then obviously I will write here D, then let us fill it up, E, then F, then G. So we are filling up the first will be alphabets. So all the blanks I have filled with the alphabets. See, four blanks are there. So A, B, C, sequentially it is coming serially. So A, B, C, then I have written D, E, F, G. Now see the numbers. Here it is 1, then 2, then 3, then it will become what? 4, then 5, then 6, then 7. Next, let us go to the next question. So this one you have understood? A1, B2, C3, then D4, E5, F6, G7. Next is given 9Z, 8Y, 7X. Now, by following this question, we can understand the numbers are in descending order and the alphabets are also in backward, reversing order. So let us first fill with the numbers 9, 8, 7. Then I will write here 6, then 5, then 4, then 3. So I have filled the numbers in descending order, reversing order. Now we will see z, before z y comes, before y x comes, see x, y, z. Now before x what comes? Before x w comes, w, x, y, z. Now before w what comes? V. Before v what comes? U. U, V, W, X, Y, Z. See, opposite way if we are coming, it is coming sequentially. Before U what comes? Before U, T comes. So, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. So, one is going serially. Both, one is, the numbers are giving descending order. And the alphabets are from backward counting. Backward, it is coming. Next. A11, B12, C13. So what we should write? Now first we will fill up the number alphabets. A, B, C. Now I will write here D, E, F, G. Now after that what should we write? Here it is 11, then 12, then 13. Then what we should write? 14, 15, 16, 17. Now one thing, please be careful children while writing. If the numbers alphabets are in capital letters, you have to fill it with capital letters. Don't write in cursive or don't write small letters. So if it is, see, the it is written in capital block capital letters, so I have written here in capital letters only. Next, 10b, 20c, 30d. So first let us fill the numbers. 10, 20, 30. It is jumping in 10. So it is jumping in 10. So I will write after 30, it will become 40, then 50, 60, and 70. So first we have written the numbers. Now the alphabets, see, B, C, D. It is going serially. So after B comes C, C, then D. So after D, E, then F, then G, then H. Okay? Next, 100, 90, 80. See, it is going backward, but it is skipping in tens. Jumping back, backward counting, but in 10. We are counting back, but the gap is of 10. So, 100, then 90, then 80. Then what comes? 70, then 60, then 50, then 40. So we are, there is a gap of 10 between each number and it is going backward. Next, 11, then 21, 31. See, here is also gap of 10. After 11 you count 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. See, gap of 10. Again from 21 to 31, it is also gap of 10. So we will write after 31 what comes? 41, then 51, 61, 71. So these are all gap of 10. We are jumping because it is very easily, you can just add 10 with the given number. So 10 with 31 you will add, you will get 41. If you are adding 10 with 41, you are getting 51. If you are adding 10 with 51, you are getting 61. If you are adding 10 with 61, you are getting 71. So how much blanks are given, you have to fill it. And be very careful about the blanks. If 4 blanks are there, you have to write down 4 numbers. If 3 blanks are there, you have to write 3 numbers. If 1 blank is there, you have to write 1 number. So don't miss the blanks. Sometimes what you do in the exam, many children do, there are 4 blanks, you are writing 3 numbers. So you are losing the marks. So be very careful while solving this type of sums. Thank you.